Well, with me, I just go back to the very beginning. I started turkey hunting when I was 8 years old. When I was 13, Mr. Rudy is his name. We call him the old swamp turkey. I swear he's three-quarter turkey. But he took me as a kid and spent time with me in the woods, showed me the ropes, showed me what to do, what to listen. And the big thing with him was patience. You know, if a turkey was in the area, just be patient. And one day we was in the Salkehatchie Swamp. Back home we have this swamp called it's a Salkehatchie Swamp. And me and him was in there sitting beneath a sweet gum tree, and we was sitting there and we were running turkey calls. And I remember him telling me, you got to slow down, you call them too fast, too loud, just slow it down, slow it down. So he helped light a fire in me to learn, or to want to learn, how to turkey call better.
So I've got a weird story. I never had a mentor to take me hunting, but when I was 12 years old, I saw an advertisement on the back of a shotgun shell box for the Jake's program with the NWTF. So in 1989, when I was 12, I became a Jake's member. But for some reason, I was just really attracted to everything about turkey hunting. My father grew up in a time, he was born in West Virginia in the 1930s, where they didn't have wild turkeys when he was growing up. They didn't have deer. He was an outdoorsman, but he didn't hunt because when he was growing up, there just weren't any animals in that part of West Virginia.
You know, I guess it goes back to, you know, I really didn't have anybody that taught me turkey hunting. But I did look up to my grandfather, who took me to the woods, and we walked, and we squirrel hunted a little bit, but it wasn't where that, you know, that father-son experience. So I didn't have that, but being able to share it with, you know, first-time hunters, it doesn't have to be a child. It can be, you know, a grown-up, and I see that too. I've had first-time hunters come in here and turkey hunt with me that just, they're addicted just as much as I am.
Oh, Gavin's won. He's won his first Grand National title this year, but he has won several state titles in Polk's division. And probably his, I know he's proud of the Grand National title. He's over the moon about it. But this year, he called in the open friction, which are all adults. And Gavin beat me, fair and square. And that was, he. He was just overjoyed about that. So
he started calling out the numbers that made top five. I was the last one. I started to shake because I was the last one to get called. And then it was me and another kid. And when they called out his number and he got second, I just immediately started to cry.
First thing, I saw Jason Hart with Gavin Bryan on stage. Gavin won the calling competition for NWTF in the Polk's division. And the smile on his face was just unbelievable. When he's holding that big long trophy up and that, I thought, well, let me bring him to the booth for Apex. So I brought him over to the booth, gave him a few items. I mean, he loved the shells I gave him. He, you know, gave him some hats and other things. And we're sitting there talking. And I realized how much this kid loved turkey hunting. I thought, well, I got nothing going on, man. Let me do something for this kid, you know. And I guess that was the 30 years of teaching that came out of me. So, you know, it was little something special I could do for a little boy.
And when Mr. Mike invited me down here to come turkey hunting, my eyes got as big as eggs.
There's a selfishness that has been inside the heart of every hunter at one point or another. The rush you get from deep, loud conversation with a hot gobbler rivals any thrill-seeking adventure one could imagine. so it is understandable how selfishness of that experience could set in one's heart. Then one day it clicks. You realize it's not about the kill. It's not about your own personal end game. It's about the path, the experience, and passing on that passion. Is it personal maturity, or is it just Father Time? One may never know. But somewhere along the way, we find the inner desire to share these experiences with friends, loved ones, and brothers of the outdoors. That the bond you create in the woods with loved ones warms your soul more than any personal success in the field ever could. Some find this later in life. Some are fortunate enough to be born into it. And those are the truly blessed.
First runner-up is number 8, Landon Weeks.